Now, Minister in charge of Northeast Affairs is Dr. Jitendra Singh, Minister of State in the Prime Minister's office. He's blamed the opposition parties of fueling the unrest, spreading misinformation that's led to this. He, of course, told me in an exclusive conversation that he hopes that the situation could be contained in the next 2 to 3 days.
The situation in Assam and in Tripura is tense, and with me is Minister for Northeast Affairs, Dr. Jitendra Singh. Dr. Jitendra Singh, the Citizenship Amendment Bill passed in Rajya Sabha, but did the government make a mistake in assessing the situation on ground, and especially in the Northeast?
No, while appreciating your concern, Gaurav, I will put it this way, that the disturbance that whatever has been witnessed in the last 2 days is in fact confined to very limited areas of Northeast. So it would not be right to say that the entire Northeast is disturbed. The disturbance, if at all, is confined to some districts of Upper Assam or maybe Tripura. And I'm sure within a few hours, very soon, this is going to calm down. Actually, there have been certain disgruntled elements which were sought to be provoked also by the Congress party in a big way, because let's not forget that over the last 5-6 years, Congress has lost its mass base in the Northeast, and one after the other, each of the 8 states have voted for BJP. So Congress thought it was perhaps a good opportunity for them to fish in the troubled waters of Brahmaputra, but I'm sure that's not going to happen.
Sir, you're blaming the Congress, but it's a BJP government in place both in Tripura and in Assam. Did Sarbanand Sonowal or Hemant Biswa Sarma or the administration, did they make a mistake in not being able to assess? I mean, it's not just Dibrugarh or Tinsukia, Silchar, Guwahati, schools, colleges, while they may remain open, but tires are being burnt, railway stations are being targeted.
Yeah, but at the same time, let's not forget that over the last 2 or 3 days, there's not been a major incident of violence. And of course, this burning of tires, etc., is something which sometimes the administration also gives leverage for a reasonable expression of the public opinion. But the public opinion, which is also being expressed, is possibly because of certain misgivings and certain misinformation which have been sought to be created in public. But I'm sure, because it is our people who are actually on the streets in the last 1 or 2 days. They are the ones who voted BJP to a huge extent, both in Lok Sabha as well as in these states. And therefore, when our representatives are among them and trying to make them understand what actually are the contents of the bill, because the contents of the bill are quite different from what is being sought to be perpetrated, and that is what is creating some kind of misgivings. But I'm sure the youth, when they understand that all these concerns which they have even today have been adequately addressed, rather more than addressed than the earlier version of the bill which came in the last Lok Sabha.
Okay, but you know, your MPs, they are saying that the situation is tense. The Chief Minister was stranded, a minister's house was pelted, an MP's house was pelted. So the youth are angry. Are these just misgivings, or is there merit in the apprehension that, you know, there'll be an influx of more refugees, even if they're Hindus or Muslims? I'm not going into the religion. There will be an influx. Assamese will take a backseat. Bangla will become the official language.
No, not really. So this is a kind of a perception which is sought to be spread. You see, as far as the influx is concerned, this citizenship is going to be conferred officially, technically, legally on those who are already there virtually. So this some kind of an allegation or charge that there'll be a cultural dilution or cultural pollution does not stand merit, because if at all there had to happen any cultural pollution, that would have already happened, or that would have already happened, because these are the people who are already living there, but living there rather illegally, to put it, you know, very candidly. Some of them have even procured the voter cards. But which has been done illegitimately. So I think Home Minister Amit Shah has tried to streamline and institutionalize the illegal residentship of these people in a more constitutional manner. So it is not going to have, because this is not going to be an added section of population which is going
so
to be.
So there will be no influx of people into Assam?
No, certainly
not. Or even Tripura?
No, certainly not, because the cutoff has already been fixed. Now, even as far as Tripura is concerned, Tripura has also been given the benefit of ILP. Yes. As far as Manipur is concerned, the assembly of the state would have to ratify the... So I think the concerns are more than addressed. Maybe the contents are yet not been fully, you know, received or or conveyed to those who are on the streets, particularly the youth.
Okay, because it's already being said that the Citizenship Amendment Bill is a violation of the Assam Accord, especially when it comes to the cut-off date. It makes it 31st of December in 2014 and not what was decided in the Assam Accord.
No, I would not get into that for the simple reason that the very sanctity, the legitimacy of this argument gets defeated when we understand that the Assam Accord itself was not put into practice. And if at all some parts of the Assam Accord have been carried forward, they have been carried forward by the present government. And to that extent, the Congress party should be rather grateful and indebted to the present government, because Assam Accord was one of the major talked about achievements or whatever by the Rajiv Gandhi regime.
Again, clause 6, where the Home Minister sought to assure people on in Assam that their linguistic identity or their cultural identity will be respected. The apprehension is Bangla will replace Assamese, you know, the Bengali culture will replace the Assamese culture.
See, I like to respond to that in two parts. As far as the language part is concerned, nowhere in the entire legislation is this mentioned that the language is going to change. So, as I said a few moments earlier, this is a kind of a misperception which is sought to be perpetrated by those who are trying to, as I said, fish in the troubled waters of River Brahmaputra. Having said that, as far as culture is concerned, most of these people are already living there. So if at all any cultural influence had to happen, it's already happened. So I think...
So there'll be no additional pressure, no additional population pressure?
Absolutely,
on Assam.
Absolutely not. And the resilience of the common mosque is there is so harmonious that I sometimes apprehend and tend to fear that this kind of provocation, which is sought to be made by certain mischievous elements, is likely to disturb that. So on the contrary, we would appeal, as Prime Minister Modi has also appealed, that there is no reason for concern and everybody has to sit down, calm down and try to understand the contents of the legislation with all its implications.
Again, normalcy to be restored by?
Yeah, sooner than later. And I'm sure this is going to be out of news in the next few hours.
Okay. Dr. Jitendra Singh, for the moment, thanks for speaking to India Today. The situation as of now is tense. Internet curbs are there on ground zero. But the minister is hopeful that the situation will improve. We'll be tracking the story very closely with cameraman Amit Gaur.